Good morning. We're here with Colby Lewis, former Major League Baseball pitcher, and as most of you know, a Bakersfield native, went to North High and BC before he broke into the majors. So he stopped by this morning to talk about the World Series, which you can watch, obviously, on Fox, our station, Fox 58. And you have first-hand experience playing in the World Series. Can the Dodgers pull it out?
I think so. I mean, yeah. They definitely have to take two out of three, that's for sure, at home. I think the Dodger fans got to definitely come in loud and strong and be ready to go to put the noise on those on the Red Sox. You got Buehler on the mound, which is it's going to be good. I think it's they don't have a lot of looks against him, so I think he's going to be pretty successful tomorrow night.
Yeah. How important is it to have that film on a pitcher or even live at-bats?
I think it's crucial for a lot of these, veteran hitters. They like to have a lot of, live at-bats and kind of know guys' techniques, different scenarios, their setup, how they kind of like to go after them as a hitter. So when you don't have a lot of looks, those guys are kind of in their blind, and, it makes for an easy day if you've got your stuff going as a pitcher, that's for sure.
Right. Speaking of pitchers, obviously Kershaw went in game one. He's been so dominant in the regular season, and his postseason struggles are kind of well documented. Having pitched in both the regular season and on the biggest stage in the World Series, what's the difference between the regular season and postseason? Why do you think it's different for a pitcher like Kershaw?
I think there can be a number of different scenarios that you can look at, but first one that kind of comes to mind is just putting extra added pressure on yourself when you don't need to. You're out there, you've got a job to do, whether it's your first start of the year or your 30th start of the year. That's the way I always kind of approached it, and that always helped me calm my nerves, calm my jitters per se. Going into a big situation or the big dance. So, I just kind of just told myself, do what makes you good, and you continue to do that. Don't overdo it. Don't think you got to throw a 97 mile an hour fastball when the 93 mile an hour fastball works just fine. So,
right.
I think that's the biggest thing is to not overdo it and just stay within yourself.
Yeah, cool. All right. So, we talked about Buehler. Obviously, the Dodgers are coming back home, so that hopefully will make a difference.
Yeah.
Any other keys that you see to the Dodgers kind of turning things around?
I think the bullpen's been really good, per se. I mean, there's only been one situation where Wood gave up the homer, and it kind of opened up game one. But I think both sides, the bullpens are still going to be, as active as ever. You're going to see if guys doesn't have it in the first inning, if Buehler doesn't have it in the first inning, it's going to be, the rest of the game is going to be a bullpen game, and they're going to try to shut it down quick. They're not going to let them go out there and struggle and walk two or three guys and surrender another game. So look for a quick hook, if he's not doing well. But hopefully he goes out there and dominates, man. I want to see pitcher stool. I'm a pitcher, so I like to see 1-0 games, 2-2 games, kind of like how the first game went. It was 2-1, 2-2, 3-2, 3-3. I love games like that, and I just hope for another great series. Hopefully it goes game six, game seven. That would be great, especially for ratings and everybody sitting around here for money wise.
There definitely is a lot of Dodger excitement around town. So
yeah. I mean, there's definitely. I'm even wearing my blue and white too.
Right.
So, I feel like I've got buddies on both sides. Played against a bunch of those guys, so I feel like I'm definitely more towards the Dodgers being from here, Bakersfield, and watching them grow up. It's going to be a tough road for them, but it's still obtainable.
Okay, great. Real quick, what are you doing these days, professional?
Working with the Rangers. I took a job back with the Texas Rangers and just kind of flying around, talking to the young guys in our minor league system. And kind of just coaching it, and I like the mental side of things, so I like to talk in between the years more than than most, because once you get drafted, I feel like everybody's got the ability. Now we got to kind of figure it out in between the years. So.
Okay, great. Well, thanks for coming in this morning.
All right, appreciate it.